Meet Emma McKeon, a sprinting powerhouse from Australia. With 11 Olympic medals, Emma is the most decorated Australian Olympian of all time in any sport. She's also won more than 30 medals in other international competitions. Emma has been an incredible relay swimmer for Australia since 2013 and has also become one of the best in the world in the 50 freestyle, 100 freestyle, 100 butterfly, and 200 freestyle. But what did she do to get there? Welcome to My Swim Pro, and today we're going to do a deep dive on Emma McKeon's swimming career, including her training and what makes her just so fast. Let's start from the beginning. Emma comes from a major swimming family. Her dad and brother are both Olympic swimmers, and her mom competed in the Commonwealth Games in the 1980s. So I think it's safe to say that swimming is in her blood. Growing up, Emma's family ran a swim school, and she was always around the pool. But despite her family's aquatic background, Emma never felt pressure to swim. She got the urge to start training when her brother David started swimming. She wanted to race too. For years, Emma and David's training was a family affair. Their dad was their coach until Emma was 18 years old. It was clear that Emma had major potential, but she wasn't so sure that she wanted to commit to the life of an elite swimmer. She had a rocky relationship with the sport, and at one point almost quit when she was 15 years old. At the time, she cared more about hanging out with her friends than training, but she stuck it out, and that certainly paid off. Emma broke onto the international scene in 2010. That year, she made it on the podium at the Junior Pan Pacific Championships, the Youth Olympics, and the World Short Course Championships. 2 years later, Emma qualified for the 2012 Australian Olympic Trials at the age of 17. She wasn't selected for the Australian Olympic team at those trials, but she had a pretty impressive showing. She placed 7th in the 100 freestyle and 9th in the 100 butterfly, 10th in the 200 free, and 13th in the 50 freestyle. When she was asked to reflect on her first trials experience, Emma said that she was crushed to not make the team, so much so that she stopped swimming for a while. Looking back, she wasn't training hard enough and wasn't focused. Emma said it was a tough lesson and she needed to learn. And from then on, she understood how much work it would take to make that team. So she put her head down and got to work. She won 2 silver medals at the 2013 World Championships in the 400 and 800 freestyle relays. In 2014, she snagged another silver in the 800 freestyle relay at the Pan Pacific Championships. She was a star at the Commonwealth Games that year too. She won a whopping 4 gold medals and 2 bronze medals. After a few solid years of competition, Emma decided to go all in for the 2016 Olympics. She moved to Queensland, swapping her father to a new coach, Michael Bowl. The move was good for her. She was forced to become more independent and even started studying at the university. She made it happen at the trials in 2016, getting selected for the Australian team along with her brother, David. She had an incredible run at the 2016 Olympics, bringing home a whopping 4 medals. She won gold in the 400 freestyle relay, helping Australia set a new world record. She grabbed silver in the 800 freestyle relay and the 400 medley relay, and a bronze in the 200 freestyle. Emma also swam the 100 butterfly, finishing in 6th place. After the Rio Olympics, she took 3 months off, and when she dove back in, she didn't pressure herself to get back to her pre-Olympic fitness. She took it day by day and enjoyed the journey, and that mindset really worked well. By the time the World Championships came around in 2017, Emma felt excited to race again. She excelled, swimming a personal best in the 100 butterfly, going a 56.1 to secure a silver medal. She also tied for 2nd with America powerhouse Katie Ledecky in the 200 freestyle. All in all, she left Budapest with 6 medals. Her trophy case was getting pretty full, and she was just getting started. Emma was back to business after her 2017 World Championship performance. After winning bronze in the 100 butterfly at the 2014 Commonwealth Games, Emma came back with vengeance in 2018 and won gold. She also took bronze in the 200 freestyle. That same year, she won 6 more medals at the Pan Pacific Championships, including 4 golds in the 400 free relay, 800 free relay, 400 medley relay, and 400 mixed medley relay. In 2019, Emma competed in the World Championships and had another incredible performance. She pulled out of the 200 freestyle due to illness, but still managed to win 6 medals, including a bronze in the 100 butterfly. She also helped the Australian team break the world record in the 800 freestyle relay. All of these performances were preparing Emma for what would be a historic Olympics in Tokyo. At 27 years old, Emma would be considered on the older end of the spectrum of all of the competitors, but she didn't let that stop her from absolutely crushing it in Tokyo. She won 7 medals. She helped Australia take gold and break the world record in the 400 freestyle relay. And then she grabbed 3 more gold medals in the 400 medley relay, 100 freestyle, 50 freestyle. She also set a new Olympic record in the 50 and 100 as well. After the 50 freestyle, Emma said she never thought she could win a 50 freestyle since she had been focusing on the 200 for so long, but she did it. She won 4 bronze medals in the 100 butterfly, 800 freestyle relay, and 400 mixed medley relay. So I think we can all agree that Tokyo was an incredible Olympics for Emma. Her 7 medal haul put her in the history books in more than one way. She set a new record for the most medals won by a female swimmer at a single Olympic Games. She also tied gymnast Maria Gorakovskaya for the most medals won in a single Games by a female athlete. She originally set this record back in 1952. Between 2016 and 2021, Emma has won 11 total Olympic medals, making her the most decorated Australian Olympian of all time in any sport. She also tied with fellow Aussie Ian Thorpe for the most Olympic golds in Australian history. They both have 5 gold medals. Incredible. After Tokyo, Emma has become a household name among swimming fans and a national hero in Australia. But with all of those accolades comes a lot of pressure. But Emma is a pro and keeps it cool, calm, and collected even in the most intense situations. Her parents have said that she has a quiet competitiveness about her. She goes out there and tries her best in every race. Emma says that she's able to switch off her mind fairly easily, which is good for high-pressure racing. She stays focused only on what she's doing in her lane. She still gets nervous, but she's learned that those nerves mean she cares about the sport and what she's doing, and uses that as fuel to swim fast. When it comes to training, Emma keeps it simple. She trusts her coach and focuses on getting in each swim every day. She does a lot of pace work to prepare her body for the 200 free, 100s, and even the 50. She films herself swimming frequently so her coach can analyze her stroke and find areas to improve. She also works with a biomechanics expert to perfect her starts, turns, and finishes. In the last few years, Emma has placed more emphasis on dryland training and has noticed a difference in how she feels the water. She even does a lot more chin-ups. When she started, she could barely do one, but now she can pump out reps with an extra 15 kilograms attached to her body. That extra strength helps her crush it on those relays, which are her favorite events to swim. That team energy and excitement is like nothing else and helps her feel more relaxed. When it comes to the individual events, Emma likes the 100 butterfly best, but she puts pressure on herself to perform in that 200 freestyle. She said that she knows she can still do it better in the 200, so look out, competition, Emma's coming for you. Ultimately though, it's not about the medals or the glory for Emma. She says that no amount of gold medals will change who she is as a person. But what she has learned from all that training and competing at the top level will stay with her for the rest of her life. We definitely have not seen the last of Emma McKeon, Australia's national hero. Comment below and let me know what you guys think of her incredible swims in Tokyo, and we'll see what's coming from her in the next competition. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe, like, let us know what you think in the comments, and we'll catch you guys next time. Happy swimming!